Good evening, Simon and his team of Hopefully Forgivers. This is David who sends in tonight's tale. A little bit of a PG thing here if you're eating, I think.
Good.
Okay. And also, there is nothing in this confession that you should try to repeat.
Okay.
Even better.
Many moons ago, in the early days of our habitation together, my wife, girlfriend as she was then, had given me a simple task. The task was simple, as I've just said. But there was a problem because my girlfriend needed an afternoon nap after her workout. We had our wedding coming up. The task was to be done without her presence, giving my young mind free rein. What was this task? Well, it was simply to remove maggots from our wheelie bin. You see, I had left the bin lid open down the side of our house, a house that backed onto the large farmer's field. When the farmer harvested his yearly crop, flies would go up in the air and they would normally fly over the houses and settle somewhere else. And that is unless someone stupid left their bin lid open and they all went in there. So a few days later, when emptying the bin from the house, I discovered my previous error of leaving the lid off when I was met with a smell and a sight of maggots all over my rubbish. Reporting it to my girlfriend, she told me that the maggots were pretty simple to get rid of. Simply pour a bottle of bleach in the bin, close the lid, and everything is fine from there, she said, before heading off for her nap. I'm not saying that's the right thing to do, and neither of the BBC. I'm just saying this is what David's girlfriend, now wife, instructed him to do. Being an imaginative young fellow at the time and being fully able to do as I saw fit, I decided there must be another way to resolve the issue without wasting money on bleach, because that is so expensive these days. A couple of quid.
What a run on that.
Looking around for items or products I could use, it suddenly hit me. And can I just say once again that there is nothing in this confession that you should be copying.
Okay.
We'd had a barbecue a few days before, and I still had some lighter fluid left. The thought process that went on now was something simple. It was a bit like this. Small controlled fire equals lots of smoke. Close the lid. Smoke kills maggots. Genius.
Unbelievable. Okay.
I mean, what could possibly go wrong? I lit a small controlled fire in the wheelie bin and the fire was going quite nicely, but then I suddenly remembered my health and safety qualification. How about that? I realised that I didn't have a bucket of water in case the fire got out of hand. Thinking safety first, I walked to the garden tap and proceeded to fill the bucket, leaving the small controlled fire to do its thing with the lid closed.
Okay.
Bobby's looking so serious and stern. Returning after what would have been no longer than 30 seconds, I was struck by how shiny the bin looked. It looked as if it had been polished. Being a man, there was, of course, only one test to see if all was well, and that test was, of course, kick it with your foot.
Oh, no.
To my shock, my toes went through the side of the shiny bin, and a backdraft of flames projected out of the hole. I then watched as my previously four-foot wheelie bin shrank to no higher than 9 inches and suddenly looked like some sort of modern art exhibit. Throwing the bucket of water over the remains and then utilising a garden hose, I managed to extinguish the fire completely, and luckily nothing other than the bin and my ego were hurt. I then did what any other self-righteous gentleman would do. I walked away and pretended nothing had happened. I mean, obviously. My girlfriend awoke and asked if I'd managed to resolve the maggot problem. Well, kind of. Yes, I responded. I suppose you could say that I have.
Yeah.
Nothing more was said for a few days until she went to empty the house bin into the wheelie bin. My girlfriend returned saying that the bin had melted and that all the rubbish was now one solid piece entwined with the bin. Quick to shift the blame, I stated that I'd seen a builder put something in our bin the other day. We lived in a new build house, so it's very common to see a builder walking around. It must have been that bloke with the cigarette and the you put the bin in the thing and they're still alight. Well, my girlfriend was furious. I'm going to write an email of complaint straight away. They could have set fire to our house. What do they think they're doing? I'll tell his reverence.
Yeah.
That's exactly the way she spoke. Like a man looking to escape all blame, I stayed perfectly quiet. Off went my girlfriend's email to the property developer's head office, and I was tasked with contacting the local council to get a replacement bin. After a quick call, it became apparent that all replacement bins cost 30 quid. Blimey, I said. The bleach would have been cheaper. What a tight-fisted guy you are. Well, it's all the builder's fault, says my girlfriend. I think they should pay the 30 quid. Definitely 100%, I said, somewhat cowardly, and off went my girlfriend's second email to the builders, demanding 30 quid. Back came a response from the builders saying that they unreservedly apologised, had dealt with the individual concerned, and that a new bin had been paid for and would arrive shortly. Now, Bobby's expression is one of outrage.
Mm-hmm.
Now, Father Simon, I do not seek forgiveness from the builder. Hopefully the telling off helped this person quit smoking.
What?
And I don't seek forgiveness from the property developers for 30 quid for the replacement bin, given that I had just bought a house from them. And I'll be paying it off for many, many years. Yeah, put that in your pipe and don't smoke it because it's not good for you. I actually seek forgiveness from my now wife, who couldn't approach the site manager anymore if we discovered a snagging issue in our house, as he would run off in the opposite direction as soon as he saw her. Well, basically, this, my guess is not forgiven all round, David, for extortion and endangering the neighbourhood. But, you know, in general, Matt forgives everybody. Let's see what happens here with Bobby, first of all, looking mad as hell.
Well, just small controlled fire in a plastic bin. I think your wife should get a new husband. That's the first thing she needs to do, because I think you're basically going to be a nightmare for the rest of your life. You're not forgiven for blaming somebody else. That is really not fair. I think it's actually worth flagging up that maybe throwing cigarettes away in the bin is, of course, a risk, and he should do that directly and say, look, would you mind?
I don't think anyone had done that, but he was just blaming it on the builder who probably smoked.
Do you know what, though? You're not forgiven.
No,
you said happily
not.
Forgive us, not from me, David. You're not forgiven.
I think he's got to be a foolish fool. Isn't he?
Yes, he has. I mean, calling it a controlled fire doesn't mean it's a fire under control.
No.
If you walk away,
if it's in a plastic bin, like Bobby says,
put it in a plastic bin. Superb. Obviously, we don't condone, but that was a very, very good story. I am going to forgive only because I think your instinct was right about let's put my melted bin in as an art installation, because I've seen worse, frankly. You know, put that in, call it the futility of hope, and suddenly everyone's paying thousands for it.
I
so
would, yes.
Yeah, you disperse, c'est moi. So yes, forgiven.